nurses all gathered round, and they gazed in wild wonder at the joy they had found. The head nurse spoke up, said, "Leave this one alone." She could tell right away.
Well, honey, what is happening, hombres? Bridget here, and before we get this video started, which I am now about to do a review of a car in Forza Horizon 4 that I've been wanting to do for so long. Now, this is a truck that I've never heard of before, which if y'all don't know by the title, but before this video can get started, I just want to let y'all know that I am actually about to begin work on Journey Through Space Season 2, Episode 3, featuring Saturn, and this episode is going to be called Saturn, Queen of the Rings, because as y'all know, Saturn is the only planet in our solar system that has visible rings, and yes, I am wearing this hat from the Nickel Plate Road 765 excursion, the number plate that I got from the excursion is right there. So, yeah, anyway, I am about to begin work on it later today, and I'm going to try and get it all set and ready to be uploaded about 2 to 3 days after New Year's. So, yeah, I just wanted to make this quick announcement for y'all so that y'all can get hyped early for the third episode of the second season of Journey Through Space, because, after Saturn, we have two more planets left, Uranus and Neptune. Now, those two are actually going to be combined into one video, unless if y'all want me to do separate videos on them, but I am planning on putting both of them into one video, which unfortunately, the second season is going to be rather short, but the third season is going to be all about the dwarf planets, starting with the dwarf planet that is in the asteroid belt called Ceres, which that's actually how you pronounce it. But yeah, I just want to make this quick announcement, and now let's get straight to the new truck. Well, hi, what is happening, hombres? Bridget here, and welcome back finally to Forza Horizon 4. God, it has been so long since I last did a video on this, but we guys are here to do a review on the brand new 2019 Hennessy Velociraptor 6x6. Now, I don't think many of y'all know what Hennessy is. Hennessy made the once proud fastest car in the world, the Hennessy Venom GT, back in 2012. And then they went on to make their own version of the Ford Raptor, which they call the Velociraptor. And this is actually a 6x6 variation of it. This one has 600 horsepower, 622 foot-pound of target, weighs 6,697 pounds. And this thing, I believe, is powered by the same engine as the 2017 Ford GT and 2017 Ford Raptor. So, let's get into this thing and let's see what it's about. Oh my... Wow! Oh my god. Alright guys, let's see how this beast sounds. Oh my god, it actually is the same engine. Man, for a 6x6, this thing doesn't actually look too bad, so let's go. Whoa! Okay, first on the road. This thing is actually not that fast. Man, this thing is actually not that bad for a 6x6 pickup. But now, I am now about to head to one of the properties up here so that I can see what I can do to this thing in terms of maxing it out. And there is a cosy there, which I'm not pulling into here, which this is thatch corner. So I guys am now about to max this thing out to see what kind of a monster that we can get out of this thing. And after that, I will look for a perfect livery for it. Okay. A 7.2-liter racing V8 or a Nissan GTR R35 V6? Nope, not going with that. Alright. Oh! No. Definitely not going to do anything with that. Although the tires here are going to be thick. Okay. Okay, y'all over there at Hennessy are now just a bunch of show-offs. Like, dude, seriously. So much customization. Well, not as much customization, but lots of upgrades that you can do. What about the roll cage? Nope. Okay, lightweight. Alright. Alrighty, now is the time to max this thing out. I think we're gonna get a shit ton of power out of this thing. Because normally a truck like this wouldn't normally get this much power. But in my case, it's getting the full package. Okay, so we're now maxed out to 979 horsepower, 890 foot-pound of torque, and overall weight of 5,033 pounds. So we just made this thing drop over 1,000 pounds. So now this thing weighs about 3 tons. Well, 6,000 pounds is like 5 tons or something like that. So, yeah. Whoa! 10 gears. This is gonna be a bitch to work with. Because 10 gears for a truck? Well, I mean, I guess that makes sense. Because a truck like this needs lots of gears to actually get moving. Okay, just do my usual tuning setup. These gears are gonna be a nightmare. Okay, I will get back to you guys once I've actually done the tuning for the gears. Okay, apparently since I maxed this thing out, apparently the highest that it can now go is 171.3 miles per hour. Which, that's good enough, but let's see what liveries that this amazing Forza Horizon 4 community has made for this monster. Ooh, there's actually some really good ones here. Let's see. Okay, so shout out to Vengeful Elite 3 for making this livery. And as soon as this is done saving, I will go into Forza Vista and have a good look at this livery. Because this livery is going to make this thing look so awesome. Well, I mean, it does look awesome already, but... And now it's double awesome. Check this thing out, guys. Look at this. Don't tell me you would not want to get a truck like this. Now, head into camera mode. Guys. Hennessy, if you're watching this, shout out to you. And no, this video is not sponsored by Hennessy. Well, not yet. But probably sometime in the far distant future, I will become sponsored, but... but right now, not anytime soon. So, yeah, I'm actually gonna be taking this thing to the Lego Valley, and I'll test it out. So yeah, I'll see y'all at Lego Valley. Okay, here we are, Lego Valley, and here we are about to test our brand new monster. Look at this thing, guys. Does this thing not look awesome? Well, in particular, someone in the Isle of Gunslingers by the name of Cattleman, aka Ink, which, Ink, if you're watching this, shout out to you, but he thinks this thing is hideous. I don't know why, but apparently he calls Ford's Dodges and all those other trucks pussy trucks. Why? I don't know, but apparently he thinks guys with trucks like this have, well, y'all probably know what I'm talking about, but I think this thing looks badass. And besides, how could you refuse to get a 6x6 Ford Raptor? Like, you just can't. You can't. It's so hard to resist a truck like this. And I bet that rednecks would love this truck. So anyway, enough chit-chat. Let's see how this thing sounds now that it's maxed out. Although, okay, I just need to do this real quick, because this is what I do every time I come back into the game. So yeah, now let's see how this thing is. Okay, this thing is awesome. And since this racetrack's behind me here, let's take this thing on there. Listen to that! And yes, I know that this thing was not meant for this, but hey, this is Forza. And in this game, you can do pretty much whatever you want with cars. Hey, the turning on this thing is actually decent. And, like, the turning on this thing is not that bad. And now, let's go off-roading. Off-roading, bitches! Here we go, guys. Time to test out this new monster from Hennessy. Here we go. Here we go. Oh my god, this thing is... Dude, this thing's off-roading like it's nothing! This thing is an absolute beast! Oops! Okay, apparently... I forget that... you could get stuck on some things here, bud. But guys, look at this thing go! This thing is just off-roading like it... like all this nothing, like it does not care. Look at this. It does not care what you throw at it. This thing's like, yo, give me all you got. Give me your worst. What do you got? Oh, what's this? Sand? Bah, that's nothing. Or how about this? Snow. What? What snow? Bah, nothing matters to me, because I just drive through it, so I don't know what you're talking about, bro. So what you talking about, bro? Water? What water? What the hell are you talking about, bro? But yeah, this thing is just a beast. I would love to get something like this. But this thing, guys, costs $349,000 to about $360,000. Like, where can you get that kind of money to get a truck like this? And to all of you rednecks out there, let me know down in the comments, would you get a truck like this to either just fuck around off-roading, or to go on family vacations, or just have some fun and all that? Totally let me know down in the comments, because I'm really curious to know what you guys would do if you got this thing? Like, for instance, would you take it to, say, like, the mountain areas and just go off-roading there and do some hiking and camping and all that? Or would you probably go to some party or something, or even to a drive-in movie theater? Because I imagine that this thing would be a perfect way to see all of your friends in the back, because look at the size of the bed on this thing. This truck bed could probably fit about, like, 10 or so people. So you and none of your friends could actually fit on the back. Well, that is, if you can somehow get that roll bar there over there, so that you can make some room for your friends. So, now there's actually a particular jump here that has been eating me alive. Well, not really, but there's one jump here that I really, really love. And back when this Lego Expansion first came out, I would just take my Molzers and I would just fly off of that ramp. So let's see if. So now let's see if I can find it. And while we're at it, let's spend some time in this thing in first person. Oh, that Mini Cooper got lucky. Oh my god. Oh my god, that landing. Dude, that landing was just... Ugh. Oof. Dude, this thing is an absolute beast. Move over, Mercedes G65 AMG 6x6. There's a new monster in town. Oh, here it is. Here's the jump. Wow. It didn't land like I... It didn't land roughly like I thought it was going to. It actually landed decently. Except that, in real life, the suspension on this thing would just break. And the landing would just be all like, ugh! And it would pretty much hurt your arse. But now let's hit this jump going back the other way to see how far I can get this thing to actually fly. Now, a truck like this is definitely capable of flying through the air. YOLO BITCHES! Fucking nail that one. I'm having the time of my life in this game, in this thing. The 2019 Hennessy Velociraptor. Okay, so that, guys, is going to wrap it up for the build and review of the 2019 Hennessy Velociraptor 6x6, a.k.a. the Ford F-150 Velociraptor 6x6, at least as I call it. So, if y'all have enjoyed this video, definitely do not forget to smash the like button and totally let me know down in the comments, would you guys ever get this thing? And if so, what would you use it for? Like having fun, going on vacation, or just to be a show-off? Totally let me know. And I will see y'all next time. Peace out, hombres.
When I hear that trumpet sound, I'm gonna rise right out of the ground. Ain't no grave can hold my body down. Well, look way down the river, and what do you think I see? I see a band of angels, and they're coming after me. Ain't no grave can hold my body down. There ain't no grave can hold my body down. Well, look down yonder, Gabriel. Put your feet on the land and sea. But Gabriel, don't you blow your trumpet till you hear from me. There ain't no grave can hold my body down. Ain't no grave can hold my body down.